This week, the chief of the Russian Navy was fired, and that comes after last month, the commander of the Black Sea Fleet was also fired. And apparently, they were both replaced because the Black Sea Fleet had taken so big losses to Ukrainian naval drones, and because they had not managed to find a solution. But here's the thing, they can fire as many commanders as they like, but it's not going to solve the absolutely disastrous situation that the Black Sea Fleet is in, because it is not a human problem. It is a technical problem. There is nothing that the Russians can do to improve the situation, so they're going to continue losing ships. So it is indeed a really bad situation for the Russian Navy, but it's not because they're incompetent or because their ships are bad. It's just that the threat from maritime drones is really difficult, and any other navy in the same situation would also be in deep trouble. So in this video, I thought I'd explain why that is the case, why maritime drones are such a big problem. So let's talk about it. I've seen a lot of people on social media making the assumption that, of course, a big warship can defend itself against maritime drones. Because what is a maritime drone? It's a kind of remote-controlled speedboat that is full of explosives, but basically it has to ram into the warship to work. And you would think that a warship can defend itself against a speedboat. And another reason why I think people assume that maritime drones should be a kind of manageable problem is that they compare them to flying drones, like the Shahed drones, because they're quite easy to shoot down. So the maritime drones should be also easy to shoot down. But both of these assumptions are wrong. And the reason is that from a technical point of view, the maritime space is much more complicated than the airspace, because the air is much more transparent than the sea. So if you put up a radar to see what's in the sky, you will get a pretty good picture of all the objects that are flying. So there would be some aircraft, some helicopters, some missiles, and if they're close enough, you can also see some birds. And then there can be some bad weather maybe sometimes that can interfere and disturb the radar, but in general, you will have a pretty complete picture of what's going on in the air. But at sea, it's different, because the way a radar works is that it sends out an electromagnetic impulse and then it listens for the echo. So if it hits an object, then there would be an echo and that would be displayed on the screen for the radar operator. And if it's an air surveillance radar, then the radar impulses are being shot into the air and you will really only get an echo if there is something big and significant up there in the air. But when you're using the same technology to look for objects that that are on the sea surface, then you run into the problem of sea clutter. And that is the echoes that are generated when the radar beam hits a wave and is then reflected back to the receiver. So the sea surface, you will have the problem that the environment in itself produces a lot of radar echoes. So you will have this constant background noise of radar echoes that are coming from the sea. And this is where the sea drones can hide. So the way this works is in practice that if you have absolutely perfectly calm weather conditions, then sea clutter is not an issue. Then you can see almost everything. You can see the birds that are sitting on the water. You can see every little boat that is moving around in your surroundings. But if there's just a little bit of waves, then you will have a circle on your radar screen where the echoes from the waves are strong enough to be represented on the screen. So outside of the circle, you will have a very nice picture and you can see ships and other objects, but inside the circle, you basically can't see anything because the echoes from the waves are so strong that there are just echoes everywhere. So if there is a ship inside of that circle, it will be hidden in the background noise. And there are, of course, different technical things you can do with your radar to try to reduce the size of that circle, but you can't make the problem go away entirely. And how big is that circle? Well, it depends, but it would not be unusual that the distance where sea clutter is a significant problem is maybe 0.3 or 0.5 nautical miles. Sometimes it can be bigger. So let's just say that in round numbers, if there's a little bit of waves on the sea, then the ship basically can't see anything that is closer than 0.5 to 1 kilometers on the radar screen. So if the drones can sneak into that circle, then we're basically down to the point where the crew on the warship will have to observe the drones visually. They can, of course, use night vision equipment and things like that, but the radar is not useful. And that also means that they also can't use weapons against the drone that depend on an input from a radar. And if you have to see anything visually at sea, especially at night, then that's just really difficult. Like anyone who has been engaged in a search and rescue exercise will know that you can basically bump into a person that is floating around in a big orange life vest in broad daylight before you will see that person. Like things just disappear. So that explains why it can be so difficult to defend yourself if your ship is being attacked by a pack of maritime drones, because we often now see that the Ukrainians will attack in packs. So the warship is attacked by maybe 5 drones at a time, that and they have different roles. You will have one drone whose job it is to keep the big overview. You will have a drone whose job it is to attract the attention of the victim. And you will have a couple of drones whose job it is to actually go in and make the kill. And if these drones get inside that circle where the radar screen becomes unusable and they're attacking at night, so they're hard to see, then the warship is in a really bad situation. And then the big question is, of course, can't they just discover the drones before they get into that circle? And that can sometimes be the case. But because these drones are so small and they are made with stealthy materials and they have stealthy shapes, then they have to get really close before they reflect an echo that is strong enough to be noticed on the radar. So you will have a very short period of time where the drone is visible on the radar before it gets into the circle where it can hide in the background noise. So this is the reason why these maritime drones are such a difficult problem to solve for the Russian Black Sea Fleet. In the future, there will absolutely be developed more robust anti-drone systems, but this technology doesn't exist yet. And it's not a problem that's going to be solved in the time frame that is the current war. It would be exactly the same problem if it were any other navy in the world. We should not expect that the US Navy or the British Royal Navy or the Danish Navy or the Dutch Navy would perform any better. I've seen some people making the comparison to the situation in the Red Sea, where the US Navy and other navies are engaged against the Houthis, and they have managed to defend themselves against drones, but those were flying drones. And as I said before, that's a much easier problem to solve. The Russian Navy can also defend itself against flying drones, but the surface drones, like, there is really not anything that Russia can do about it. I think if you wanted to solve the problem with the technology that exists today, then you would have to rely very heavily on air power. You would have to have maritime patrol aircraft and helicopters in the area to discover these drones and to kill them. And preferably, you would also have air power to dominate the coastline so that you can prevent the enemy from even launching the drones. But this is not something that Russia can do because they don't have that kind of control in the air, and they don't have the capabilities that they need for that. So that is why the situation is so bad for the Black Sea Fleet. It doesn't matter how many high-ranking officers they fire, because they're going to continue losing ships, because at this point, it's just an unsolvable problem. Okay, I will end it here. If you found the video helpful or informative, then please give it a like. And also remember, you can subscribe to the channel and you can click the bell icon, then you will get notifications when I upload new videos. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you again next time.